Hey everybody, it's Eric Sachs over at Breakthrough Broker. So happy to have my good friend and national speaker, Chelsea Peitz, on the call today. As you guys know, she is one of the foremost Facebook and Instagram coaches, authors, trainers in the industry. So Chelsea, welcome. Awesome to have you today.
Thank you so much. I'm so excited to be here and come back because I've got new stuff. Yay.
Yeah, I was super excited to tell everybody. So this is hot off the press. Chelsea has not presented this content yet. She has not taught this. So this is first to our Breakthrough Broker audience. So thank you, Chelsea. And I think it's fun because I'm really a firm believer that a lot of the Facebook and Instagram and social media education in general, throughout most local areas, I've heard from realtors is getting a little stale. And when I ask real estate agents at many of the classes we teach, if they're kind of sick of hearing about social media, that most of their hands raise. And so I love having Chelsea on because what she does is cutting edge. She's so in tune and with what's going on. I think this, none of this is stale content. It's something that can help you guys build your social media through time. So Chelsea, welcome. Some house cleaning if you guys have questions, because Chelsea gets going fast sometimes. If you have questions, ask them. We will address the questions at the end of Chelsea's presentation, as many as we can. And then this is being recorded, so I know a lot of you always ask me during the presentation if it's being recorded. So yes, it's being recorded. We'll get this out to everyone who registered for the event later today. So let me get Chelsea going here as a presenter. And let me make sure, there we go. This is always the tricky part, right, Chelsea?
Exactly.
make a presenter. Okay. Did you get it?
Let's see. Let me click the button and you let me know. Can you see everything?
I can.
Yay. Wonderful. Yay. Perfect. Okay. Well, I am ready to go and I'm very excited. So thanks again to Breakthrough Broker. Today, I really wanted to bring you a little bit more about Instagram because it's great that we learn how to use social media and all of that. But we want to know, how do we generate business? So I'm bringing you 7 ways to generate more leads with Instagram in 2020. And as Eric said, quite a bit of this is going to be new. So let's go ahead and dive in. First thing is first here, I want to make sure that we are connected on Instagram. So make sure that you write this down, connect with me. I will follow you and talk with you. I give weekly Instagram tips and training on IGTV, which guess what we're going to talk about today? That's right, IGTV. So if you guys have questions and you're like, what the heck is it? How do I use it? I'm going to get into that. I'm going to give you some tips and tricks. Also, for those of you who love to listen to podcasts, you might want to subscribe to my podcast called The Voice of Social Sales. I was honored this year at Inman to be nominated for an Innovator of the Year Award for that podcast. I drop lots of tips and interview people from all over the world that are experts in marketing beyond just social media. So let's get started. Tip number one, you guys, is we need to be switching from a personal Instagram account to a business account. So before you get worried because you're thinking Facebook business page, totally different. Now, when we're in Facebook and we have our personal profile and then we create a business page, should you want to do Facebook ads, boosted posts, etc., what happens with the business page, and you probably noticed, is that sometimes your algorithm can get what's called downranked, meaning you don't get as much free reach on your business page. That is not the case on Instagram. In fact, switching from a personal to a business account on Instagram is all win for you. And here's what the wins are. Number one, you get several different buttons that make it easy for people to reach you via text, via direct message, via call, via website. So here's the benefit. Remember, guys, if I'm on Instagram, your Instagram profile is now your website. Okay? I'm not going to leave Instagram and write down a number or a URL and leave Instagram and go to your website. So now we have to think about, how do we make our Instagram profile our website? The business account is one way to do that. So all you have to do is, number one, you have to make sure that you have a Facebook business page set up. So that's step number one. These are going to be connected. So you have to have a Facebook business page. And then from here, you go into your Instagram account. You're going to go to your profile. You go to settings, and you're going to switch your account to business. Now, it's very easy to do. It is a one button toggle switch. You can go back at any time. So if you decide you don't want to do the business account anymore, you don't like it, you can switch back. The additional benefits that you get as a business account on Instagram, number one, you can run ads, and running ads on Instagram is affordable and it's very effective and will become much more popular in the next coming years. Okay, you can retarget people that have visited your profile. You can create custom audiences. Very easy to do. You might want to do Instagram story ads, which we're going to be talking about later today. You have to have a business account to do that. The other piece is those extra buttons that you can get so people can reach out to you directly through Instagram. And then last but not least, you get a lot of analytics and insights, and you need to be looking at those. So if you've never gone in and looked at your insights, which is basically data on engagement rates, likes on your posts, comments on your posts, you will not know what is working. I will tell you from personal experience, I thought that there was a type of post that was working for my audience. It turns out, after I looked at my analytics, the stuff I thought was working wasn't working, and the stuff that I didn't think was working was. So I started making more of that, and guess what? I generated more business, more clicks, more leads, all of those things. So you have to have your business page, you need to go into your account on Instagram, and you need to set up your business profile. It does not downrank your algorithm, it just gives you all the benefits. One caveat here, if you are using Instagram stories, which we're also going to be talking about today, and you have connected your Instagram stories to auto post to your Facebook stories, you will no longer have that connection. Okay, so here's why you will no longer have that connection. You can only cross post or auto post from a personal to a personal, or a business to a business. So if you switch to business account on Instagram, it will no longer go to your personal Facebook stories. Okay, so I just want you to be aware of that. What do you do to solve that? Well, you're either going to have to download and save your Instagram stories and then upload them into your Facebook stories, or you'll have to make original stories on both platforms. Okay, so step number one, business account is what you're going to want. Step number two is critical. And I see a lot of folks not really spending some time to go into their profile and really maximize it. Again, your Instagram profile is now your website. When people go on there, you have less than 30 seconds to get them to, one, follow you, two, potentially click a button, maybe direct message you, and three, click the link on your bio. And the link on your bio is gold, you guys. When you can get people to click the link on your bio, which should go to a landing page with hopefully lead capture, you may have a Facebook pixel installed, which is totally free, and that means you can retarget people just like what happens to us when we go to Amazon. We may put something in our basket, but we don't purchase it, and then all of a sudden, all throughout the internet, Facebook and Instagram and all other places, we are getting ads that say, hey, reminder, you wanted to buy this. So let's talk about your profile. If you have your phone in front of you, get it out right now. Do this with me. Let's go and look at your profile. The first thing you need to look at, your username and your name section. Now the username, if you're looking at the image on the screen here, is at the very top. That's your at sign, your at handle, what your name is in Instagram. So if somebody says, how do I find you on Instagram? Whatever name you give them, that is what your username is. Mine is chelsea.pites. What I recommend on a side note is that you try to keep your usernames the same across all of the socials so people can find you easily. So your username, in my opinion, should be your first and last name or a variation of that, or your brand or team name if you have one of those. But remember, people are going to be typing in your name and looking for you if they get a referral, and they want to make sure that it's you. So your username is at the top. If you look at the photo, my profile photo, directly under that, it says social media and Instagram tips. Now that is the name section. Now when you're editing your profile, it says name. in that little category. And so it makes sense to us to put our name there. But what I will tell you is that the username and the name section are the only two searchable areas of your profile, which means if you have your first and last name in both areas, you will only get found for your first and last name. But if you have your first and last name or your brand name or your team name in one of those areas, and then you have keywords in the other, I suggest in the name section, like I have it, you could potentially be found by consumers and potentially create leads. For example, you might have San Diego Homes, San Diego Lifestyle. I don't recommend using words like realtor, mortgage, real estate, because let's be honest, consumers aren't going to Instagram and typing in the word realtor into the search term. Okay, we got to think in the consumer's mindset. So tip number one, make sure your username is who you are, your first name, last name, or brand name, and then your name section should contain keywords that will help you get found. The next tip is to create what I call a unique value proposition as the actual bio. So I have it abbreviated here, UVP. Now, if you look at mine, it says, I share real estate marketing tips that help you grow your business and make more money doing what you love. I'm going to give you a little formula for how to create your own on the next slide. My point with this is I want your bio to be simple, to the point, and tell people what they can expect or what the benefit is from working with you. You can do bullet points if you want. You can do sort of emojis if you want to have it look a little bit more visually appealing. I think getting right to the point and being simple, jargon-free is critical. Now, you may have noticed on Instagram profiles, they are now cutting off or truncating a lot of that profile. So the first sentence is really the only thing that shows. So make sure you're making that statement, that impact statement in the very first line, because some people may not click the see more. So you have to use your UVP as a bio or let people know what to expect. When people read mine, they know exactly what they're going to get by going to my profile. They're going to get real estate marketing tips, and those tips are going to help them grow their business. Okay, so make sure you have something simple, jargon-free. The next thing I don't see a lot of people doing, which is critical, is adding a call to action in your bio. Now, you'll see here, I've got two. You only need one. You can have more than one, but one is critical, and it's showing at the very bottom of my actual bio section, which will layer right above my link. So I've done that on purpose. So when you're editing your profile, put that call to action sentence at the very last sentence. And then when you post it to your profile, it will show right above your link. Now I have helpful downloads here. What I don't recommend is click here, learn more. Little bit different if you're doing like an ad in Facebook, those would be things that you could put on your call to action button. When you are on Instagram, you need to entice people. Why do I want to click that link? Start my free home search. Do you have any free guides? Do you have off-market properties? What do you have that is of interest to me that I want to really click that link in your bio? Okay, so call to action is the third tip for your profile. Now, at the very bottom here, you can see that I have Instagram story highlights, and I put in here for bingeable content. Think of ourselves now as Netflix, as YouTube channels. When people are coming here as your website, they are not going to leave. So you need to give them as much context about you and who you are as possible, because if I wanted to stalk you to see if I wanted to work with you, I would want as much content as possible. If I went on someone's YouTube channel, I'd want to binge on their content. If I had a Netflix series, I'd want to watch it all. My recommendations, you do minimum of 5 highlights, because then it will go across the whole screen. And you put in there possibly testimonials from clients. You could put in different areas that you work. You could put in buyer tips, seller tips. You could do best places to eat in whatever community you're serving. You could also do personal things, your favorite hobbies, family stuff, whatever seems right for you and your brand. But I definitely recommend that you start creating those Instagram story highlights. Now, I promised you I was going to give you a formula for your unique value proposition for your bio, and here it is. I do what, for whom, that results in. I do what, for whom, that results in. And I have a little asterisk there that says jargon free. And the reason I say jargon free is because extraordinary service isn't going to set you apart. It's not going to tell people what the benefit is of working with you. So for example, for all your real estate needs, service from start to finish, those are really more mottos, maybe taglines, but not a unique value proposition. So my challenge for you guys before 2020 is to nail this down one sentence with that formula, okay? Also, when we talk about the link in your bio, Instagram only gives you one link. You might have noticed that they are not allowing you to copy and paste any hyperlinked or clickable URLs anywhere else within Instagram, not in your captions or anywhere else. You have one link. My recommendation for you is when you have that call to action that's enticing to get people to click on that link, make sure it's worth their while once they do it. Now, I am using a freemium website called Linktree. They have a free version and they have also a $6 a month paid version. I'm using the $6 a month paid version. You do not have to. I wanted it to look very branded. You can see I have my branding on the background and I've got a variety of different buttons that somebody could click on. My first one, because my call to action is a free download, is a button that says free download. And because this is just a still image, what you can't see is that when this opens up, and you can see this live if you guys go to my my profile and click the link, the free download button actually moves. So it grabs that attention. It basically says, click me, and people know exactly where they are, what to do, and they're in the right place. So definitely get Linktree, set that up. It's very easy to do, and then you can maximize the links that are happening into your bio, okay? So I did also talk about Instagram story highlights. Here are some great friends of mine and also Breakthrough Broker. And they have examples of highlights. I just wanted to show you what these look like here so that you know kind of what we're talking about and maybe what they should look like. And I said make four or five. My reason for that is if you look at the bottom here, the fourth one usually gets cut off. So I just want it to look full, like it's a complete lineup that goes across the bottom. Keep in mind, these are specific for Instagram stories. So you can't go to your camera roll and upload a video or a photo that you haven't actually posted to your story first. So we will talk about stories in a moment, but this is an example of the Instagram story highlights. I love how all three of these accounts have branded and it looks very cohesive with their branding and their colors as well. So how do you make a highlight? You just go to your profile. You'll tap the plus sign inside of the circle. You'll see below your profile and in between your actual grid of photos. You can just tap on that plus sign. It will then ask you to select the stories that you want to add into that particular highlight. I just think of a highlight as like an album. So think of it like a photo album or a content album. And you can put up to 100 stories per highlight. There is no limit on how many highlights you have. You can go in and edit them at any time. And you can also edit those by simply going to your profile. And if you long press or press and hold down on any of your highlights, this little menu that you see here will pop up and you can delete it. You can edit the highlight and you can copy the highlight link and send it to people. My pro tip for you guys, build them in reverse order, meaning whatever little highlight you want to show up first in the lineup, you have to build or create last, because as you're building these highlights, they start to move to the right, if that makes sense. So if you are like, oh, I want to do buyer tips and have that be my number one thing, the first thing people see, you're going to want to make the three other ones first and then make the buyer tips highlight last. Okay. Now in this other picture on the right here, where it says edit cover, there's the pink with the hashtag. I'm just giving you a visual that you can actually add cover photos or cover art to all of your highlights so that you can make them look a little bit more branded or cohesive. Not required, but just a quick, easy little tip. You can actually create something in canva.com and you can save it to your camera roll and it will allow you to select a cover photo from any of your saved photos in camera roll. All right, number three, you guys, this is probably one of your favorite things you're gonna learn today, is using hashtags the right way to generate leads. The only way, I shouldn't say the only way, the main way to grow your following and exposure in Instagram is through appropriate hashtagging. So here are the common mistakes that I'm seeing with hashtags. Number one is not using enough hashtags. Now I have 20 to 30 there. Your maximum is 30. That's in the feed post. Okay, I'm not talking about stories, talking about your feed post, your main feed post. Now, I know 30 sounds like a lot, and it is. And sometimes getting to 30 is really hard. I'm going to teach you how to do the research and how I make it a little bit easier on myself to save time with my hashtags. Think of it this way, you guys. Think of playing the lottery. If somebody said, I'm going to give you a bunch of lottery tickets and you don't even have to pay for them, would you rather have one lottery ticket or would you rather have 25? We would all say 25. You cannot win if you don't play. The more, the better. And it is absolutely true that, you know, 20 to 25, it could even be 15 to 25. If you can get more to 20, that's ideal. Now, if you've read blogs or heard articles or seen videos about, you know, big brands are performing better with less hashtags, it's because they're big brands. If you're Nike and you have millions of followers on your Instagram account, for sure, you can get away with not using a lot of hashtags. Okay, so just read through those blogs carefully and understand they're typically talking about large brands. Number two is not using different quote sizes of hashtags. Don't worry, I have a whole slide on this if you're not understanding what the sizes are. It just means, is it a more popular hashtag? Is it a less popular, more niche hashtag? And I have in here low millions to low 1000s. What that means is, when I show you how to do the hashtag research, it will always show you how many posts are using that hashtag right under it. So it always has a number associated with that hashtag. That number tells you, is this really popular? Like hashtag love is super popular. It has hundreds of millions of posts that use it versus hashtag, you know, real estate life may only have 200,000 uses. So we're going to talk about how you can research and look at those numbers, but I see a lot of people using either really big hashtags, but they're not layering larger, more popular hashtags with medium size, less popular, with very small niche custom hashtags. The third mistake I see is not using relevant, consumer-focused hashtags. I talked about this briefly in the beginning, using hashtag realtor, hashtag real estate agent, hashtag top producer, those types of hashtags are typically not going to help you get found by the right people. Local hashtags, lifestyle hashtags, decor, things as simple as like Joanna Gaines style, farmhouse design. When we go to Instagram, as somebody who is, you know, purchasing a house myself, I want to go for inspiration. I want to see beautiful homes and decor and design and different areas that I might be living in. So we need to think about what are they using as the consumer. Okay, so how do we research hashtags? You guys, I don't use any fancy stuff. I use Instagram. I don't use any paid services. All you have to do is go to a relevant account, maybe somebody else in your industry that is, you know, making posts and getting some good engagement. They're getting some likes and comments. And when you tap on their post, as you can see here in my example, it opens up their post caption and you can see at the bottom, this is one of my posts, all those blue hashtags. Now they're blue because they're hyperlinked, meaning I can click on any of those hashtags and it will take me to what I call the hashtag gallery or the hashtag hub. So let me show you what that looks like next. This is what I call the hashtag gallery. So imagine I just went back here, okay? So realtor life is one of my hashtags. I click on that, and now it's going to pull up the hashtag gallery. At the top, you'll see the hashtag I tapped on. In this case, it's hashtag real estate life. Right underneath that, on the left-hand side, you see a reddish colored outline circle. Those are any Instagram stories that are currently using the hashtag real estate life in the story. Then you see the number 1.9 million. That means 1.9 million posts have used that hashtag. Then right under the number is the blue button that says follow. It's my suggestion that if you're using a variety of hashtags, maybe 10, 20, 30 over and over again, that you start following those hashtags. The reason why is because you will see what other content is showing up in there, and they will actually put in posts into your feed that have been using that hashtag and allow you to connect with other people and potentially find new content. Now, my favorite part in the hashtag gallery is right under the follow button, and you can see it's kind of hard to see, it's in gray. It says the word related. That is what I also click on. So I've got my original hashtag, which is real estate life, And then I have related, and you can see here it says real estate agents, it says homes for sale, and there's a few others. So you can scroll through that. That is what I click on, and I simply just notate what the numbers are that are in that result. So the follow button we talked about, related hashtags, super important. You can also see that under those related hashtags, there's the word top and the word recent. Now you can tap on either one, doesn't matter. Just so you know what the difference is, the top means those are the highest performing posts or videos, and the recent is chronological order, the most recent posts. You can tap into any of those posts and do the same process on any of their hashtags. The other way that you can explore and search hashtags is simply going to the Explore tab, which is at the very bottom of your home feed. You'll see the small magnifying glass. If you tap that, there is a blank search box at the very top, and I can tap in or type in any word. For this example, it shows travel. Now, a key here is that when you're typing in a keyword, you want to make sure that you have tapped on the word tags. You can see across the top, I have top, people, tags, places. You want to make sure that you are tapping on tags because that's going to show you hashtags and the numbers associated with it. So you can see right here, there are all these numbers, hashtag travel, 238 million posts. Now, this is a good time to talk about the using the wrong sizes. You never want to use a really large hashtag. Really large is anything over about 2 million. I even say 1.5 million. So for here, let's see, travel is too big, traveling, travel blogger, travel photography, all too big. You see traveler's notebook, it's 1, 2, 3, 4, fifth one down, 1.5. So that is way better. That would be our largest one that we're going to use. And you want to get a couple that are in that million to 1.5 million. Then we want to look at six figures. Then we want to look at five figures. Then we want to look at four figures. And that's how you want to layer those hashtags, okay? So here's what I do. I go through my phone, and this is actually some of my hashtags that I use, and I make a simple spreadsheet. And yes, this takes time. I'm going to tell you right now, on a Saturday afternoon, you can watch a movie on Netflix, take your phone out, and get this all done in 2 hours, and then it's done forever, okay? So I have a column here. The green one is for low millions, and I've organized all those hashtags by the size. Then the next one over, I have six figures, and then five figures and four figures. This is where I store all of my hashtags and do my research. So now I know how large those hashtags are. So when we're looking at trying to get to our 20 or 30, we pull a few from the millions, a few from the six figures, a few from the five, and a few from the four. That's how you create your hashtag set. Then what I do is I just pull out the notes in my phone. I type them in there. This is an actual screenshot from my phone. And now I can copy and paste them into my captions. You don't want to use the same hashtags every single caption because it will look a little spammy to the bot detectors on Instagram. So you want to have probably 5 to 10 different sets of hashtag groupings in different sizes that reach that 20 to 25 mark. So each one of these might be, you know, 25 hashtags, different sizes, etc. That is the ninja secret to hashtags, okay? Here's another example. This is a visual example too, so probably your favorite slide here. So you can see up here, I've got my 3 to 5 moderately popular, those are my low millions, my 5 to 7 six figures, my 5 to 7 five figures, my 3 to 5 four figures. Okay, this is how we make the hashtags. Okay, so you guys will get that after the webinar is over. Okay, so where to place them? I get this question all the time, you guys. It does not matter if you put them in the caption. Doesn't matter if you put them in the first comment. My recommendation is to keep them in the caption because it has to do with the timing of when you actually post the original hashtags. They're doing some testing, and it has shown that captions are where you're going to want to place them. So it's really more of an aesthetic preference, but my recommendation is within the caption itself. All right, hashtag pro tips as a review, doesn't matter where you place them. Smaller niche hashtags, better for the feed. If you're going to put a hashtag in a story, you are okay to use a larger or more popular hashtag. Do not try to hide your hashtags in the stories. They're on to you. And if you try to shrink them down, they're going to see that. It's not going to register. Three is your max in a story. Okay, I recommend one per story. So that's a little bit opposite of the feed. We're doing 20 to 30 in the feed. We're doing 1 to 3 in the stories. I do recommend creating your own branded hashtag. That is something that's custom to you. For example, mine is Chelsea Chat, and I use that on all of my posts. I don't recommend using hashtags in your bio or your profile unless they're branded. Hashtag realtor is not going to be good for you because it will send people away from your page, away from your profile, and into that hashtag gallery of millions of other people's posts. I would recommend following relevant hashtags, including your own branded hashtag, so you can see if other people are using it. And I also recommend using the exact same hashtag formula that I just showed you here in your IGTV video descriptions. Hashtags are going to work for IGTV in the future. All right, speaking of IGTV, it is now time for us to embrace the YouTube of Instagram. They're trying to get longer form content and videos onto Instagram, and there is a benefit if you know how to use it right. So first thing you need to do, download IGTV app. I don't know why they made a standalone app, but they did. So you'll need to set up your account by simply downloading the IGTV app, going in there and clicking create channel, and then follow the three easy steps to connect it to your account. The nice thing is that it's already connected to everyone you follow. You do not have to go and follow all the people or invite them to, you know, follow you on your IGTV. You can easily upload a video. It has to be a minimum of 15 seconds. It can be a maximum of 10 minutes. You can upload vertical or horizontal. Now, it's not sorted, so you can't have playlists. So if you're used to YouTube, there's no playlist yet. I believe that is coming. The nice thing also is you can upload videos on desktop Instagram or just through your phone. And you can also add these mini previews of your IGTV videos to your feed, the main feed, as well as your profile grid of all your pictures. Now, what's interesting is that they are adding IGTV videos to you, the Explore tab, so you could get a lot more exposure through there. And I believe that the hashtags will start to eventually help those IGTV videos show up in search, which is why you want to start using them now. Now, I told you there was a little trick, a tip to IGTV. There is something called the preview option, and you always want to use the preview option because they are going to give you more reach, more exposure. They're going to give you more eyeballs onto your IGTV video, which will in turn help you grow your followers and get more leads because you'll get people to your profile and potentially get clicks on the link. So here's what you need to know. Your video has to be over 1 minute in order to do the preview option. It has to have a short, catchy title. You can see the word title there. You want to make it short because it's very small. So it's like a 1-inch little square. So you don't want to put a whole bunch of words in there. People can't read it. In the description section, you can put links, which are clickable, which is awesome. So if you have a blog link, a website link, a podcast link, put it in there. I'll also use the hashtags, have a call to action, tell people what to do, to comment, to click the link, etc. And then you can also share your Instagram TV to your story, which I'm going to show you. But the number one thing you need to make sure is that you are clicking that post a preview button. Turn it on. Turn that toggle button on. It will do the heavy lifting for you and get your IGTV video out to more people. Now, a quick tip here too, right now, not a lot of people are using IGTV cover photos. So if you look at this example here, you see that one that says at parenting quick tips. Now to me, that stands out because it has a nice clean cover photo. My recommendation is you guys put cover photos on your IGTV videos. It gives you the option when you're uploading your video to add a cover photo. You can simply make it, save it to your camera roll, and upload it. It will help you stand out. I use easel.com, or you can always use canva.com, which is great as well. So just to give you a quick update too, this is a visual. If you're making a cover photo for your IGTV, it will change the size depending on where it's posted. So if you're making a cover photo and you have words on it, make sure you don't put it up too high or too low, because when it posts that preview to the feed, it's gonna go from this green one of the 9x16, that one on the left-hand side, it's gonna get cut into a square, which is all the way over to the right, the 1x1, the yellow. So if you have like text at the top or bottom, it'll get cut off. So just be aware of that. Now, I told you I was gonna teach you how to share your IGTV video to your story. What you do is you make your IGTV video, you post it and upload it, then you go to your Instagram stories. You make a little Instagram story, it's the first picture here, And then after you've made your video or your photo, you will see a chain link icon where the little hand is pointing up there appear. Now, when you tap on that, it's going to then bring you to this next screen, which is the second image that says IGTV video. Then you click on the different video. You might have, if you only have one video, it's going to be the only one that shows up. If you have a whole bunch of IGTV videos, you'll be able to scroll through and pick which one you want. And then what I like to do is after I have linked the video that I want, I like to add a GIF that's a swipe up GIF so that people know they need to swipe up. So there's a little tip to get more views on your IGTV. Don't forget to check your analytics. If you go on to your IGTV video, you can swipe up and view insights. You can see, are people sticking around? Are they watching the whole video? Do you have views, likes, comments? So definitely check that out. My favorite apps for my IGTV videos, if you go to my account, you'll see a whole bunch of them. I'm using VideoShop. It's totally free. iOS and Android, you can add filters, you can add text, you can add GIFs. I love it, and like I said, I love the price, it's zero. Also, I'm using InShot. You can take horizontal video, and you can turn it into a vertical video or vice versa. So if you need something from YouTube and you wanna post it to your Instagram TV and it's vertical format, you can change that as well. I believe it's $2.99, it is iOS and Android. So we're gonna talk really quickly about Stories. I'm sure a lot of you are using it. Want to give you a couple of tips on the stickers. Location stickers, you guys, will help you get views and help you get found. My tip on this, small niche locations, not Phoenix, not San Diego. Pick a small location, a specific building or area, because you might get shown in 3 to 4 search results instead of one large one. So maximize your exposure, smaller niche location stickers in your stories. Definitely use the poll stickers. Instagram is watching. They're looking to see, are you using our poll stickers? Are you getting engagement? Guess what? They're going to roll out and already have just recently rolled out poll stickers on Instagram story ads. It's a big deal to Instagram. Use the ask question stickers because they're looking again. Are you using the stickers? Are you creating conversation? Are you getting direct messages? And it's a fun way to create conversation with your viewers. Hashtags and stories. We covered this. It's one hashtag sticker or up to 3 written out in text. First example is the picture of the sticker. The second one here is if you just use the hashtag symbol and the text, only 3. Do not shrink them down. Add calls to action. Direct messages are heavily weighted engagement factors and do affect your algorithm positively. So you want to make sure that you are direct messaging with people. So let them know, like this picture here, message me, draw an arrow, and encourage people to talk with you. Share your content to your story. If you're doing a feed post, you can share your feed post to your story. A lot of people may not be going through your feed. They may miss it, but if they're watching your story, you can drive more traffic, more comments, more engagement to that post. And then also look what who's watching your stories, guys, because this is the only social media that allows you to see who is watching your story. Now, if we have a Facebook Live or a post, the only way we know somebody has consumed it is if they comment or if they like it. Not so here. You can have people not comment or like, and they're just watching. So definitely go and see who's watching. I recommend that if somebody follows you, you watch their story, like a couple of their posts, and I would send them a voice message thanking them for connecting with you. When you send a voice message, it's more human. Also, it tells the algorithm, hey, we're having a conversation, so my content should be at the beginning of their feed lineup. Branding, potentially more leads, okay? So here's your pro tips for stories that we just went through, you guys. Sticker placement is important. If you're placing it too far to the edge, people are going to accidentally tap forward. The music sticker, people ask me all the time, it's going to be gone if you have the business account. You can't cross-post business Instagram to personal Facebook. We talked about that. I think you should change your angles of your face if you're talking, kind of talking head. People like to see movement. And if you guys want to know how you can get the swipe up hack for under 10,000 followers, if you're wondering how people say swipe up, I've got a little IGTV video on that. So make sure you go check out my channel. You'll be able to find out that hack that I just posted. All right, number 6, we've got one more after this, you guys. Instagram story swipe up ads. This is courtesy of a good friend of mine, Jason Cassidy, who gave an ad over at the Inman conference. And this was his exact ad. How simple, you guys. For dollars a day, a dollar, $2, $5 a day, you can serve an Instagram story ad to your entire database, to all of your followers, to people you don't know. Now, Instagram story ad templates, promo.com, easel.com. So definitely sign up for those. You can make some quick Instagram story ad templates. If you're wondering how to get that Instagram story ad, just go into your Facebook ads manager in the edit placement. You will see down in Instagram where this arrow is here. You can actually just select stories and it will show up in between the stories. Cool thing is, you guys, if you're doing Instagram swipe up ads, you can retarget. Here's an example. I can retarget anyone who's looked at my business profile, engaged with any post or ad, sent a message, etc. So think about adding that. I mentioned you can add poll stickers to IG story ads. So if you're looking for that, there's a tiny little button when you're creating the ad that says add an interactive poll. Okay, so think about using that in your Instagram story swipe up ads as well. Last but not least, another way to generate leads, and this is a really simple, easy change you can do, the scheduling and planning. You guys, if you have an iOS phone, download this today. It's called When to Post, okay? I use it all the time. It gives me the best times for me, for my account, because it connects to Instagram, of when to post to get the highest engagement. If you don't have an iPhone and you have a Droid, you're gonna have to pay. You might wanna use Preview, and I believe it might be $5 to $7 a month. So I'm sorry about that. Another option you have is to get your business account and to look at when people are online. But if you have an iOS, it's a lucky day. When to Post is your new favorite app. Brand new, starting this week, Instagram Creator Studio. If you are using a third-party schedule and you're paying, like I am, Planoly, Later, Preview, any of those things, guess what? You may not have to anymore because Instagram just announced Instagram Creator Studio. This is an online dashboard that is free to anyone with a business account or a creator account for Instagram. You can manage your posts. You can schedule your posts. You can explore insights and you can check all of your messages, which is awesome. So just to let you guys know, you may not have this yet, creator account. I just got it this week. Same place I talked about changing a business account. Go in there today, see if you have the creator option. All the way down at the bottom, it says switch to creator account. And here's a little screenshot I took with my phone. I'm testing it out right now. I think it's awesome so far. Here's a website you need to make sure you guys write this down. business.facebook.com/creator-studio. You guys, go there today. This is brand new. Hardly anybody is using it. It is a free tool scheduling your Instagram and IGTV posts. This will help you save time. It is awesome. You can see what's working, which will help you create more better content to create better leads. Here's just a couple of screenshots. When you go to that website, this is what you'll see. You connect to Instagram. You can see everything all in one place. You can see your videos, your photos, your stories, you guys. You can even see story performance. All of this right here at your fingertips. And then you can post directly from the desktop with your keyboard. I am so excited about that because I am tired of posting on my phone. So you guys can schedule too, just like a Facebook business page. So get on there, try it out. Make sure you're connected with me here on Instagram for weekly tips and training. Eric, I'm ready for Q&A. How about you?
I love it. That was so awesome. I'm taking notes. I was on my Instagram. I was changing stuff. I love it. Good job.
Yeah.
For those of you, it's definitely going to be emailed out to you later today, the recording of this. And I'm going to ask Chelsea about 5 questions.
Okay.
Is it easy to use poll and ask question stickers?
Yes, all you have to do is you have to make a story first. So if you are opening up your camera and you're like, where are these icons, these little sticker icons? Let me see if I can actually go back and find an example to show. You just tap on the sticker icon and then there will be, so it's hard to see right here, but there's a little icon up here. And if you tap on that, it opens up a menu and there is a poll, it says poll. And so just look for the word that says poll. And you tap it, and what happens is you can type in a question, whatever question you want. It's kind of like a yes or no or this or that. And then your answers, you can also type in. You can use words or you can use emojis. And it's a really fun way to have people engage. You might have a picture of a more traditional style home, a more modern home, and you could have that like side by side and say, which one do you like better? You know, this one or this one? And people can engage with you that way.
And you post those to your stories, correct?
You post those to your stories, yes. And so that would look like that. And here's the question sticker right here. And then you can see who's answered them. And the cool thing is on the question, you can share it. This is the answers that the person got or the questions they received, and then they can share it to their story. But the nice thing is it's anonymous. So if you engaged with me, Eric, and I wanted to share your question that you sent me, but I didn't want anybody to know who it was, not to worry, it's totally anonymous.
Awesome, that's awesome. What, real quickly, what were the video apps for editing called again?
Let me find those. Video Shop, you guys, right here. Video Shop is my favorite. And InShot, InShot. They are available for both iPhone and Android. Video Shop is free with a, you know, upgrade of some sort for bells and whistles. And I believe InShot, same thing. Remove the watermark for $2.99, one-time fee.
Okay, cool. Should hashtags be all lowercase?
They will automatically basically just make them lowercase for you. So I know it's sometimes people try to do longer ones or multiple words and make like the first word of each, you know, new word capitalized, but it will automatically just lowercase everything for you.
Okay. What, can you do any of this from your laptop?
Yes, now you are going to be able to. So that's why I'm so excited about this, which is the Instagram Creator Studio. This is all desktop, but the caveat is you have to have either a business Instagram account or switch to the new creator option. Doesn't matter which one you do, but now you can do everything from your desktop, which is awesome.
That's great. Laura asks, can we hire you to manage our social media?
Smiley face. Oh, thank you so much for that compliment.
Let's see what else.
No, but I appreciate you asking.
I knew the answer to that.
Yeah.
Let's see what else. How do you get bullet points into your bio?
Bullet points in the bio. Let me go up here to show you some of those. So when you are going into your bio, you guys, there is a button right here that says edit profile. Okay, you click the edit profile button, and I'm gonna kind of show you pictures here. So the way like Katie has here, she's got a little emoji. You can use emojis as bullets, or you can, you know, actually just put in like a little hyphen there. When you click edit profile, it brings up a box where you can type in either your UVP or just some, you know, words or phrases. And a lot of people like to use emojis as bullet points. Now in mine, I'm not using any bullet points and just have my sentence, but this, it's kind of hard to see these gray little squares. Those are actually emojis. It's at the very end, close to where the flags are, the poor, unloved, unused emojis that live down there. This is another example I had where I used those gray square emojis as bullet points as well.
Love it. Awesome. Well, Chelsea, thank you so much. I'm sure we'll have you again on this show sometime, either this year or next year. I can't thank you enough for being on. Everybody, this will be recorded. We'll get back out. We might separate some of these clips and turn them into little pieces of content on Breakthrough Broker as well. So you guys, thank you for coming, everybody. We have Travis Tom, who's also one of Chelsea and my dearest friends, who I believe is one of the foremost Facebook marketers. Chelsea, yes, no?
Yes, in the world. He is the foremost like paid advertising Instagram and Facebook expert in the world. He's amazing.
We have him on next month, so everybody keep an eye out for your Breakthrough Broker invites to our webinar, and we'll see everybody next month. Everybody have a great end. I know all the kids are going back to school, so let's get into September and rock and roll. Thanks, Chelsea. I'll see you soon. Thanks, everybody.